So, in the previous class, up to transpose of the matrix concept is over and the problems depends on transpose of the matrix is completed. Then we are going to discuss inverse of the matrix. So, A is any square matrix. You take A, B, C, D like that. This is 2x2 matrix. So A is any square matrix and B is another matrix. Then AB is equal to BA is equal to I. A is any square matrix. B is another square matrix. Then AB is equal to BA is equal to I. Then we say that B is the inverse of A. B is the inverse of A. So A is any matrix, any square matrix. A is any square matrix and B is another square matrix. Then AB is equal to BA is equal to. Already you know in matrix multiplication, AB is always not equals to BA. But in this case, we get AB is equal to BA is equal to, you get I. I is the identity matrix. Then B is the inverse of A. B is the inverse of A. And it is denoted by, it is denoted by A inverse. That is, B is equal to A inverse. A is any square matrix is given. B is any matrix, it is also a square matrix. Then AB is equal to BA is equal to I. I is the identity matrix. Then we say that B is the inverse of A. So B is inverse of A is denoted by A inverse. That is here B is the inverse of A. That's why B is equal to A inverse. That's why you write A inverse into A into A inverse. Instead of A, B, you substitute A inverse. A into A inverse. A inverse into A is equals to I. A into A inverse is equal to A inverse into A is equal to I. So the inverse of A is A inverse. So here I tell one point. A inverse, inverse of any matrix is unique. Inverse of any square matrix is unique. That means, for example, A is any matrix. They have a inverse, A inverse. This A inverse is unique. You have inverse is only one matrix is there. That is, inverse is unique. So what is the definition of inverse of the matrix? A is any square matrix. Then B is any square matrix. Then AB is equal to BA is equal to I. I is the identity matrix. Then we say that B is the inverse of A and it is denoted by A inverse. That is B is equal to A inverse. Write the definition. So write the definition. Inverse matrix. Inverse matrix. Capital A is any square matrix. Capital A is any square matrix. And B is any square matrix. And B is any square matrix. Then B is said to be inverse of A if AB is equal to BA is equal to I. Then B is said to be inverse of A if AB is equal to BA is equal to I. AB is equal to BA is equal to I. I is the identity matrix. In bracket, you write identity matrix. Identity matrix. A is any square matrix and B is any square matrix, then B is said to be inverse of A. If AB is equal to BA is equal to I, and it is denoted by A inverse, and it is denoted by A inverse, that is B is equal to A inverse. B is equal to A inverse. That implies A into A inverse is equal to A inverse into A is equals to I. A into A inverse is equal to A inverse into A is equal to I. Note. Inverse of a square matrix, inverse of a square matrix is unique. Inverse of a square matrix is unique. Inverse of a square matrix is unique. We want to prove this statement. We want to prove this. We have a just a small proof is there. We want to prove this. Inverse of a square matrix is unique. Every square matrix inverse is exist. That inverse is always unique. That means that matrix has only one inverse, not two inverses and three inverses like that. Only one inverse. For example, take B and C are inverse of A. We want to prove this. Inverse of a matrix is unique. For example, take B and C are inverse of A. By using the definition, B is the inverse of A, then AB is equal to BA is equal to I. For example, B is the inverse of A, then AB is equal to BA is equal to I. B is inverse of A implies AB is equal to BA is equal to I. C is inverse of A. C is inverse of A. That implies you get AC is equal to CA is equal to I. For example, you consider C is the inverse of A, then AC is equal to CA is equal to I. Then we want to prove B is equal to C. We will try to prove. We get B is equal to C. Then we say that inverse is unique. Here, what we considered, B and C are two matrices. B and C are the inverse of A. For example, we consider two inverses are there. That is, B is one inverse and C is another inverse. By the definition of inverse matrix, A is inverse of A, then AB is equal to BA is equal to I. By definition of inverse matrix, C is the inverse of A, then AC is equal to CA is equal to I. Here, compulsory, we want to prove B is equal to C. Then we proved B is equal to C means A has only one inverse, that is unique inverse. That is, we consider B. B is equal to BI. Every matrix is multiplied with identity matrix. You get the same matrix. I discussed the identity property in matrix multiplication. Every matrix is multiplied with their identity matrix, then you get the same matrix. That's why B is equal to BI. Both are same. Here, instead of I, instead of I, you substitute AC. Instead of I, you substitute AC. AC is equal to I. That's why instead of I, you substitute AC. In matrix multiplication, associative law is satisfied. That is AB into C is equal to A into BC. Already we proved in matrix multiplication, associative law is satisfied. Here, this is BA into C. Since associative law is satisfied in matrix multiplication, associative law is satisfied in matrix multiplication. So we consider B. B is equal to BI. Why? Any matrix is multiplied with the identity matrix, you get the same matrix. B is equal to BI. So instead of I, you substitute AC. Here AC is there. AC is equal to I. So matrix multiplication is associative. That's why B into AC is BA into C. So BA is what? BA is equal to I. You substitute I here, IC. Identity matrix into C matrix is equal to, you get again C. So you get B is equal to C. Here we take B and C are two matrices. B is the inverse of A and C is the inverse of A. At last we proved B is equal to C. That means every matrix has a unique inverse. That is only one inverse. Hence, inverse is unique. That's the proof. This is a small proof. A square matrix has unique inverse like this. Any square matrix have unique inverse. Next, another proof of a theorem. Yes, what's that proof? Prove that theorem, important. Prove that AB whole inverse is equal to B inverse into A inverse. Very, very important theorem. AB whole inverse is equal to B inverse into A inverse. We want to prove this. Already know, for example, X is any matrix. X into X inverse is equal to I. This is the definition of inverse matrix. A is any matrix. A inverse is the inverse of A. Then A into A inverse is equal to I. A inverse into A is equal to I. Like that. AB is any matrix. AB is any matrix. AB into AB inverse is equal to I. A into A inverse is equal to I. Already we learned the definition of inverse matrix. A into A inverse is equal to I. Here also same definition I am using. AB is any matrix. AB is any matrix. AB into inverse of AB is AB power minus 1. That is AB inverse is equal to I. Then multiplying both sides with A inverse. A inverse into AB into AB whole inverse is equal to A inverse into I. Here multiplying the inverse of A with the left multiplication on left side, on left side, that is A inverse into AB inverse is equal to A inverse into I. Here matrix multiplication is associative. Then you get A inverse into A into B into AB whole inverse is equal to A inverse into I is A inverse. A inverse is a matrix. Any matrix is multiplying with I, you get the same matrix. That is A inverse. Here matrix multiplication is associative. Then here A inverse into A is equal to I. I into B is into AB whole inverse is equal to A inverse. So IB into you get B into AB inverse is equal to A inverse. Then again multiplying both sides with B inverse, left multiplication. That implies B inverse into B into AB whole inverse is equal to B inverse into A inverse. Again multiplying both sides with left multiplication. That is B inverse into B into AB whole inverse. Here B inverse into B is I. I into AB whole inverse is equal to B inverse into A inverse. Then AB whole inverse is a matrix. This is multiplied with identity matrix. You get the same matrix. That implies AB whole inverse is equal to B inverse into A inverse. B inverse into A inverse. Then you get. This is the proof. Very, very important proof. So AB whole inverse is equal to B inverse into A inverse. So multiplying, for example, you take LHS. Yes. You can use the property, that is a definition. A into A inverse is equal to I, not LHS. A into A inverse is equal to I. By using this definition, that is AB is a matrix, then AB into AB inverse is equal to I. Then multiplying both sides, left multiplication with A inverse. Here matrix multiplication is associative. You change the bracket. That is A inverse into A into B is equal to AB whole inverse is equal to A inverse into I is A inverse. Then here A inverse into A is equal to I. So IB into AB whole inverse is equal to A inverse. I into B is again you get B into AB whole inverse is equal to A inverse. Again multiplying with the B inverse on both sides, left multiplication. That is B inverse into B into AB whole inverse is equal to B inverse into A inverse. So B inverse into B is again I. So I into AB whole inverse is equal to B inverse into A inverse. That is I into this matrix is again this matrix. That is AB whole inverse is equal to B inverse into A inverse. This is the what is meant by inverse of the matrix and inverse of a matrix. Inverse of any matrix is unique and AB whole inverse is equal to B inverse into A inverse. Next, make a heading. elementary operation on matrix. Elementary operations on operations operation of a matrix. Elementary operation of a matrix. What is meant by operations? For example, if A is matrix is given 1, 2, minus 1, 3 is given. Here you consider this is the first row R1. This is the second row. This is R2. Identification. For example, this is the column, first column, you make it is C1. This is the second column, that is, you make it is C2. For example, I can do one operation. R1 double implies R2. What is the meaning of this? Meaning of this means you can change the R1 in place of R2, R2 in place of R1. Then you get the matrix is what? Interchange the rows and columns. Minus 1, 3, 1, 2. This is the operation. This is called elementary operation. For example, R1 goes to some 2 into R2. What is the meaning of this? You can multiply with R2 and substitute in place of R1. So, what is R1 here? What is R1 is minus 1, 3. So, R1 goes to 2R2. That is 2R2. R2 is what? 1. Instead of R2, first element is 1. 1 into 2 is 2. And here, 2 into 2 is 4. You substitute instead of next. R2 goes to 3R2. R2 goes to 3R2. Directly, R2 plays. Substitute 3 into 1, 3. 3 into 2, 6. Like that. These are called operations. For example, this. Take C1 goes to C1 plus 2C2. C1 goes to C1 plus C2. C1 goes to means you write instead of C1. What you write? This operation is right. That is C1. C1 is 1. 1. Plus 2 into C2. C2 is 2. 2. That is 1 plus 2 to 4. That is 5. You get 5 here. Next. Second element. C1. C1. That is minus 1. Plus 2 into C2. 2 into 3. That is 6. Minus 1 plus 6 is equal to 5. That is, you write 5 here instead of C. Then you write C2 is same, 2, 3. That's it. These are called elementary operations. These operations are called elementary operations. Don't confusion. Sir, again, I can discuss some more examples. You take any A is equal to minus 1, 2, 1. 3, 2, minus 1, 0, 5, 2. This is 3 by 3 matrix. This is R1, R2, R3. C1, C2, C3. Like that. R1 goes to R1 plus 3R2. This is the operation. R1 goes to means you write instead of R1. What you write instead of R1? R1 plus 3R2. What is R1 here? First element minus 1 plus 3 into R2 first element 3. 3, 3 is 9. 9 minus 1, 8. Write 8 here. Next, second element 2 plus R1 plus, that is 2 plus 3 into R2. 3 into 2 here. That is 6 plus 2, 8. Again, 8 here. R1, what is R1? 1 plus 3 into R2 is minus 1. That is 1 minus 3. 1 minus 3 is minus 2. So minus 2 here. For example, another operation. R2 goes to R2 plus R3. R2 goes to R2 plus R3. So instead of R2, you substitute adding R2 and R3 elements. That is 3 plus 0, 3. 2 plus 5, 7. Minus 1 plus 2, 1. Instead of R1, R2, you write instead of R2. What you write instead of R2? R2 plus R3. That is 0, 3 plus 0, 3. 2 plus 5, 7. Minus 1 plus 2, 1. R3, you write the same R3. 0, 5. For example, you require next operation. That implies next operation. C1 goes to 1 by 2 C3. C2 goes to C2 plus 1 by 2 C3. This is the operation we require. C1 goes to 1 by 2 C1. C1 is this. Instead of C1, you write what you write? 1 by 2 C3. So C3 is this. 1 by 2 C3 is what? 1 by 2 into C3 is minus 2. You get minus 1. Right here, minus 1. Next, 1 by 2 C3. That is 1 by 2 into 1. Second element. One third column, second element. 1. That is 1 by 2 here. Next, 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 into third element in C3 third element into 2, that is 1, 1 here, that is C1 goes to 1 by 2 C3. So instead of C1, you can write 1 by 2 into C3, apply the operation 1 by 2 C3, then you write instead of C1. Next, C2 goes to C2 plus 1 by 2 C3. So you can do this operation and write instead of C2. So, C2 plus 1 by 2, C3. C2 is what? 8. First element, 8 plus 1 by 2 into C3. That is minus 2. 2 to cancel. That is 8 minus 1, 7. Here, 7. Next, C2 plus, that is 7 plus 1 by 2 into 1. 7 plus 1 by 2 into 1. Then you get 7 plus 1 by 2. LCM 14 plus 1, 15 by 2. So you write 15 by 2 here. Next, 5 plus 1 by 2 into 2. 2 to cancel. 5 plus 1, 6. That is 6 here. So third column is the same. You write minus 2, 1 and 2. This is called elementary operations. Elementary operations of a matrix. Right? Example. Example. Directly write. Let us take A is equal to this matrix. A is equal to minus 1, 2, 1. 3, 2, minus 1. 0, 5, 2. And write this this operation. This operation. R1 goes to R1 plus 3R2. I think everyone understood what going on here. Elementary operations. This is very, very important for next upcoming chapter, that is determinants. In every problem, you can do this operation on rough work. Completing in rough work, then write the element here. That's enough. Don't write here. This rough work is not right here. Inside the rough work, you write inside the rough work this calculation and direct element is right here only. After this, apply the operation. C1 goes to 1 by 2 C3. C2 goes to C2 plus 1 by 2 C3. this is not definition. Definition of elementary operation of a matrix. It is not a definition. It is working process. C1 goes to 1 by 2 C3. C2 goes to C2 plus 1 by 2 C3. Let us practice another operation. A is equal to matrix minus 1, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 2, 0, 4. Apply the operation. R1 goes to 2R2 plus R3. R1 goes to 2R2 plus R3. So instead of R1, you substitute what you substitute 2R2 plus R3. What is 2R2? 2 into R2 first element is 6 plus R3 element is 2. That is 12 plus 2. That is equal to 14. That is 14. Next, second element in R2, 2 into 8 plus third element, second element in R3, that is 0, 2, 8, 16, that is 16 here. Next, third element in R2, that is 2 into 10 plus third element in R3, 4. That is 20 plus 4, 24. So R1 goes to 2R2 plus R3 means apply the operation 2R2 plus R3, then write the elements in R1. Next, R2 goes to R2 minus 2R3. R2 goes to R2 minus 2R3. Yes. R2. R2 first element 6 minus R3 first element 2 into 2. That is 6 minus 4, 2. That is 2 here. R2 second element 8 minus 2 into R3, that is 0. That is 8 minus 0, 8. 8 here. 10 minus 2 into R3. 2 into R3 is 4. That is 10 minus 8. 10 minus 8 is 2. That is 2 here. For example, here operation R3 goes to 1 by 2 R3. R3 goes to 1 by 2 R3. Yes, instead of R3, dividing R3 elements with 2, then write that is 2 by 2, 1, 0 by 2, 0, 4 by 2, 2. This is the operation. Like that in C1, C2, C3 operations also, column operations. These operations are called elementary operations of a matrix. These operations are called elementary operations of a matrix. By using these operations, we want to find out the inverse of the given a square matrix, right? By using this row or column operations we find out the inverse of any square matrix how to find out the inverse of a given square matrix by using this row or column operations I discuss only row operations because in 3.4 exercises very important for 3 marks question a 2 by 2 matrix is always in you can observe the previous papers in previous papers for 3 marks or 2 marks question I think 2 or 3 marks questions they given find the inverse of the matrix any 2 by 2 matrix by using elementary operations this is the given by using elementary operations find the inverse of square matrix that is always they given 2 by 2 matrix for example a is any 2 by 2 matrix by using only row operations a is equal to ia what is the meaning of this a is equal to ia is correct a square matrix is multiplied with ai then you get the same matrix you can take this relation a is equal to ia both side apply the row operations only then you get a inverse this is I you get here I is equal to a inverse into a apply the row operations then you can change this a matrix into I matrix by using row operations you can change a matrix into I matrix same operations are applied here you take a is equal to ia by using row operations you can change the a matrix into I matrix same operations apply here on I same operations apply on I here at last you get here you get I then you get here a inverse why I is nothing but a inverse into a that's why this is the inverse of a this is the process I discussed one or two problems you understood easily yes right by using elementary operations write a problem example problem by using elementary operations find the inverse of the matrix a is equal to matrix 1 2 2 minus 1 1 2 2 minus 1 by using elementary operations find the inverse of the matrix A is equal to 1 2 2 1 yes solution listen carefully A is equal to IA you take for every problem you take A is equal to IA what is A here 1 2 2 minus 1 is equal to I is 1 0 0 1 here you write only A like that only a here apply the our task is apply the row operations you make this matrix is I apply by using row operations you make this matrix is I matrix. As usually, you can apply the same operations on this matrix also. Okay. For example, what is I matrix? This is 1. You make this is 1. You make this is 1. And you make this value is 0. And this value is 0. That is by using only row operations, not column operations. First, I'm using the operation R2 goes to R2 minus 2R1. Observe this. R2 here, 2 is there. 2 minus 2 into 1, 2. 2 minus 2, 0. Here. We required 1 here. Already 1 is there. You make this element is, first you make this element is 0. For this, you make this element is 0. For this element is 0, you can use the operation R2 goes to R2 minus 2R1. Why here 1 is there? 2 into 1 is 2. 2 minus 2, you get 0. That's why apply this here. You write the first row is same. 1, 2. First row is same. Here, change the R2 only. That is 2 minus 2 into R1, 1. That is 2 minus 2. That is equal to 0. Here, second element. Minus 1 minus 2 into 2 here. You observe this. Minus 1. Minus 1 minus 2 into 2 here. That is minus 1 minus 4. Then you get minus 5. Here minus 5 is equal to. Here also same. Apply the same operation here. 1, 0. First row is same. Apply this on second row. On second row. That is 0. R2, 0 minus 2 into 1 here. 0 minus 2 into 1. That is equal to minus 2. Here minus 2. Next, 1 minus 2 into 0 here. That is 1 minus 0. That is equal to 1. This is 1. Here A. That's enough. Next. Then you make this element is 0. You make this element is 0. Here 1 is there. Here 0 is there. We required this element is 0. For this element is 0, you can multiply it with 5 and adding this 5. Minus 5. You can multiply it with 5 or other way, in another way. R2 goes to R2 by minus 5. R2 goes to R2 by minus 5. You get this one here. That is 1, 2. R2 goes to R2 by 0, 5. 0 by minus 5, 0. Minus 5 by minus 5, 1. Is equal to here. First row same 1, 0. Second row R2 by minus 5. Minus 2 by minus 5. 2 by 5. And 1 by minus 5. That is minus 1 by 5. Into A. So here you get 1. We required 0 here. That's why. R1 goes to R1 minus 2R2. R1 goes to R1 minus 2R2. Here, I got these operations. For example, you go your way. At last, I required is here. You make I, then you get A inverse automatically here. That is R1 goes to R1 minus 2R2. That is, what is the element here? R1, 1, 1, 1 minus 2 into 0, 1 minus 2 into 0, 0, 1 minus 0, 1, here 2 minus 2 into 1, 2, that is 0. Already second row 0, 1. Same operation apply here. R1 goes to R1 minus 2R2. R1 goes to R1 minus 2R2. That is 1 minus 2 into 2 by 5. 1 minus 2 into 2 by 5. That is 1 minus 4 by 5. You get 1 by 5. That is 1 by 5 here. Next, R1 goes to R1 minus 2R2. That is 0. 0 minus 2 into minus 1 by 5. Then you get minus into minus plus. Plus 2 by 5. Plus 2 by 5. Then R2 is the same. You write 2 by 5 minus 1 by 5 into A. Observe this. This is I. I is equal to, for example, this is A. A inverse into A should be I. A inverse into A is I. That's why this is A inverse. Therefore, I is equal to A inverse into A. A inverse is equal to matrix 1 by 5, 2 by 5, 2 by 5, minus 1 by 5. This is the process. You can use only row operations, not in column operations. For example, if you take A is equal to AI, A is equal to AI, then you can use only column operations. A is equal to IA, you can use only row operations. A is equal to AI, you can use only column operations. But here, we can follow only one method. But you can follow both the methods. That is, it should be confusion. That's why what I'm saying, you follow only one method. That is row operations method. Everyone must follow row operations method. That is, you can take A is equal to IA. Then apply only row operations. You can convert this matrix is I. Automatically, here you get A inverse. What operations applied here, you can do the same operations on I also. What operations you can do here, you can apply the same operations on I also. That's why you get A inverse. This is the I have some idea on operations. I can do like this. You have some idea, different ideas. You can use that ideas, at last you get the same answer. You can use the different operations also. You get, at last you get I is equal to A inverse into A. Then you get the same answer. You and me get the same answer. That's why you can use your own operations. That is the practice. You must practice more number of problems. You can do the problem is very easily. It is very, very important. Compulsory problem in examination for 3 marks or 2 marks. I don't know. I think it should be a 3 marks. Yes. Exercise 3.4. Very, very important exercise. Exercise 3.4. Time on the hurry. Time. Got 10 minutes. Okay. Yes, first problem. Using elementary operations find inverse of A is equal to 1 minus 1 2 3 1 minus 1 2 3. Using elementary operations, find the inverse of A. A is 1 minus 1 2 3. Solution: to take A is equal to IA, that is 1 minus 1 2 3 is equal to I matrix 1 0 0 1 into A. But here, first some rules are followed. What are the rules? Is first, this is 1, you required 1 here, otherwise here 2 is given. First you go for this is 0, you make this element is 0, then you make this element is 0. First you make this element is 0. Here which element is given, not discussed here. Here first you make this element is 0, then you make this element is 0. That is the first task. So for first, this element is 0, that is R2 goes to R2 minus 2R1. So here 1 is there, 2 minus 2 into 1, 2, 2 minus 2, 0. Yes, apply that operation. Here first row is same, 1 minus 1. Second row, 2 minus 2 into 1, 2, 2 minus 2, 0. Here 3 minus 2 into minus 1, that is 3 plus 2, that is equal to 5. You get 5 here. So same operation apply on I also. That is first row same, 1 0, second row 0 minus 2 into 1, 0 minus 2 into 1, 2, that is minus 2. Next, 1 minus 2 into 0, 1 minus 2 into 0, that is 1 minus 0, that is 1, 1, A. Next. You make this element is 0. After that, you don't change this element by using your wrong operations. Don't use wrong operations. That is, you can use wrong operations. This element is changes. This element is changes, you go in wrong way. So that is the next. You make this element is 0 by using this row. So you can multiply with minus 1 into 5. Minus 5. Then adding this, minus 5 plus 5, you get 0. That's why R1 goes to, R1 goes to 5R1 plus R2. Observe this operation. R1 goes to 5R1, 5 into minus 1, minus 5 plus 5, you get 0. Apply this operation, that is R1. Here, first row, R1, that is 1, 5R1. That is 5R1 means 5 into 1, 5, plus adding 0, plus R2 is 0. That is, you get 5 here. In R1, first element, 5, 1, 1 into 5, 5, plus R2, first element, 0. 5 plus 0, 5. Next. Here, R1, first element, 5 into minus 1 plus 5, R2 second element, 5, that is minus 5 plus 5, 0, 5, 5 into minus 1, minus 5 plus 5, that is 0. You write the R2 is same. 0, 5. Same operation apply here. Same operation. That is 5 into 1, 5 plus minus 2. 5 into 1, 5 plus minus 2. 5 minus 2, 3. Next. 5 into 0 plus 1. 5 into 0 plus 1. That is 0 plus 1, 1. So R2 same. Minus 2, 1. Into A. I think you understood. So here, this is very easy to make. This is 1 and this is 1. R1 goes to R1 by 5, R2 goes to R2 by 5. R1 goes to R1 by 5 and R2 goes to R2 by 5. That is 5 by 5, 1, 0 by 5, 0, 0 by 5, 0, 5 by 5, 1 is equal to, here also, 3 by 5, 1 by 5, minus 2 by 5, 1 by 5, into A. Observe this. This is I is equal to A inverse into A. Therefore, A inverse is equal to matrix 3 by 5, 1 by 5, minus 2 by 5, 1 by 5. 3 by 5, 1 by 5, minus 2 by 5, 1 by 5. The second bit, using elementary operations, find inverse of A is equal to 2111. Sanitize install చేసుకుంటున్నాం yes students you can do in own way okay tomorrow we will continue thank you